In this tutorial, we are going to overview the entire class, Social Statistics, Sociology 3123. The first question we're going to address is, what is statistics? Statistics is nothing more than a set of procedures, used to organize, arrange, and communicate data. That leads to the question, what are data? Data are nothing more than information that's represented by numbers. This is the basic focus of our course, and we're going to delve into this a little more closely. One way to think about statistics, it absolutely is a set of procedures used to organize, arrange, and communicate about data. But a simple way to think about statistics is the role that it plays. Statistics is a part of the larger scientific or research process. And that research process starts with a simple research question. It's the starting point for the scientific process or the research process. We start with a research question that basically asks a question about the world we live in. From there, we devise a plan, a study, to collect data. We go out and collect those data, and then we have all this information. The next step is to analyze the data. This is the stuff of statistics. Statistics is the analysis of data. Once we analyze those data, which in fact provides the answer to our research question, and once we have that answer, it leads to more questions. So the research process is this circular pattern that never ends. Answering one question just leads to another. And statistics, the analysis of data, is the final step in that process. This research question that we start with are generally one of two types. Our research questions are either descriptive in nature or explanatory and sometimes called predictive. These are the two basic types of questions we might have. So what is a descriptive question? This is a question that might ask, how many? What does a group look like? What does the subject we're interested in look like? How many of them are there? So for example, we might be interested in a simple question like, what is the average income in the United States? And that's a descriptive question in nature. Just ask, how much money do people have on average? How much money do they make annually on average? An explanatory or predictive question examines the relationship between two things. So we may know the average income in the United States, but then we may move on to another question. What helps us explain that income? Perhaps one's education level might help us explain income. That is an explanatory or predictive. Does knowing education help us predict or explain income? So those are the two basic types of research questions that we'll have. Now, these questions can be answered under two circumstances. Okay? Under two circumstances. When we have population data and or if we have sample data. And as we'll learn later in this course, a sample is just a relatively small subset from the entire population. And when we have sample data, we have to do an additional step. We have to infer how well our sample represents our population. And that's the third component of the course. So we're going to focus on descriptive statistics, explanatory or predictive statistics, and inferential statistics. And to be sure, we can calculate descriptive statistics using sample data or predictive or explanatory statistics with sample data. The defining feature of inferential statistics is whether we have sample data. Key to this course is understanding data and the variables that represent those data. So we know that data is information represented by numbers. These numbers represent variables. What is a variable? A variable is simply a characteristic of interest to us that varies from one observation to another, from one person to another. These variables are key to understanding statistical analysis. So suppose we have two people, and this person, person A we'll call them, is a white male, age 21, with a 3.1 GPA. We have another person, person B here, that is a black female, age 23, with a 3.7 GPA. Notice all of these descriptors, white, male, 21, 3.1, and so forth. These are variables or characteristics that vary from one observation to the other. And we're interested in either describing these variables or predicting these variables. What helps us predict GPA, for example? How many females or black females are there in the group we're interested in? These are the types of questions we're going to be addressing throughout this course. So variables are absolutely key. So we're going to also talk just a moment about how we think about variables. Variables are distinguished along the lines of what's known as level of measurement. This concept is absolutely key to understanding the material in this course and what we'll be doing from this point forward. Level of a measurement simply means that variables differ, and they differ along this level of measurement, which means more specifically how much information each variable type can provide to us. And we have several different levels of measurement, and for this course we're going to categorize all variables into one of three levels of measurement: nominal, ordinal, or interval ratio. So we're going to distinguish a variable that is considered nominal, ordinal, or interval ratio. Nominal variables are those variables that only allow us to distinguish between two observations. So a variable such as race. An individual can be white, black, Asian, and so forth. And we can distinguish those individuals along this variable race, but that's all we can do is distinguish them. We can't rank them and we can't do anything else. We can't say that a black person has more race than a white person, or an Asian person has more race than a black person. All we can do is distinguish into nominal or named categories. Ordinal variables, on the other hand, as the name implies, allow us to order the categories of the variable. We can say that one category represents more of that variable than another. A simple example of an ordinal variable is social class. We can say that someone might identify as from lower class, middle class, upper class. And we can certainly say that someone that is in the upper class has more socioeconomic status or social class than someone in the lower class. What we can't say is precisely how much more social class they have. We can only say that one is more than the other. Which leads us to our final level of measurement, interval ratio. Again, it allows us to categorize just like a nominal variable. It allows us to rank order like an ordinal variable, but it adds an additional piece of information such that we know the precise amount of difference between the categories. So age is a good example of an interval ratio. If someone is 21 and another person is 28, we can say that 28 is different than 21. We can say 28 is more than 21, and we can say precisely how much more 28 is than 21. That means we know the interval between the categories. Understanding this concept, level of measurement, is absolutely critical. And here's why. We're going to talk about lots of different statistical procedures. All of them fall into the categories that I already outlined here: descriptive or predictive, and inferential if the data are sample data. We're going to talk about several descriptive statistics. We're going to talk about several predictive statistics. Which descriptive statistic do we use? Which predictive statistic do we use? It depends on level of measurement of the variables. What descriptive statistic we use depends on the level of measurement of that variable we're trying to describe. What predictive statistic we use depends on the level of measurement of the independent and dependent variable that we'll describe in more detail later in this course. But absolutely, positively key here, level of measurement.